rabble, I expect. What is the commotion?
Help! There's been an accident!
Oh, Jacob, Evie, it's you. Thank goodness.
Experimenting, are we, Alec?
Correct.
And looking a bit frazzled.
Nerves. It's those great oafs Static keeps sending round to coax me. He is offering a ridiculous amount of money.
Alec, you're not thinking of jumping ship, are you?
Never. I've been working in something in case they get too insistent. It's meant to stun an assailant, should the need arise.
Are you certain that it works?
Not as such. I've made three of them with varying degrees of acidity and whatnot. Oh, one must be the right formula.
Let's find some Staric lackeys to target then, shall we?
Speaking of Staric, he is still transmitting false information.
We could simply destroy his transmitters.
His company's too well guarded. The bombs will help, but it would be awkward to produce bombs that potentially do not stun. Oh, wait a minute. Looks like opportunity has come knocking. Oh dear, they never looked so angry before.
Stand clear, Alec.
Let us instead play a little linguistic game with them. Take the bombs and climb onto the roof. When I see the name of a fruit, toss one near the thugs.
Right then.
Oh, wait, I nearly forgot. Slip these into your boots and you will henceforth be immune to all voltaic discharge. I think.
Gentlemen, I would ask you in for tea, but I'm afraid I'm running rather late.
Enough of the niceties. We've come to smash your place up, ain't we, Bess?
You got one of them telly what's-its in here, ain't ya? You've been reading messages from the Staric Company.
That is as untrue as the notion that the Staric Telegraph Company is emitting impartial information, sir.
Come again?
Your employer's promises are nothing but hot air. His operations are about to turn pear-shaped.
What you going on about air and pears for?
Oh, I don't know, feel rough.
Those playful young scamps get everywhere.
that bell or I'll thump you till your ears are ringing.
Oh, I've won. You know what play delights me? And to think I worried you had the mental agility of a dollop of donkey's apples.
I think he's trying to be funny.
Oh, you dropped a no on Bill. You little sod.
Well, ain't me, Bez. God, blimey, it's coming now.
Oh, those rascals throwing stink bombs again. It happens all the time around here.
Where you keep that telly, what's it? I'll count to three.
Three? Well, well, let's see how far you get.
One.
Do you really think I would keep it here? Do you see a cable? A telegraph without a cable is about as useful as a bell without a clapper.
I'll give you a bleeding clapper.
Well, bless my boots, you're as purple as a plum.
I feel all wobbly, Baz.
You are in shock, my dear fellow.
Someone's up to no good.
Good show, Alec.
One more with a pompous
thanks to you, Evie. Your mere presence gave me courage and resolve I never knew I had.
I'm glad I could help. Now it's time to shut down Stark's empire of propaganda.
The longer we can keep Starek from spewing out false information, the more we can awaken the people with the truth about his operations.
I agree. The sooner we can get there, the quicker we can act.
Would you believe my mother says there are still some wives in her street that swear by that soothing cell? So I tell us the truth about the noxious draft.
That's good, Alec. But you can't go round to every household in the town.
No, I wasn't always welcome. It shows how false information can be as difficult to stamp out as fishwives' profanities at Billingsgate.
And at Smithfield.
But if we can eradicate a source that continually feeds such detrimental trash, then little by little the truth will take the upper hand and the sham will be flushed out.
That's why we're here.
We will have to get in without being detected, mate.
I shall stand on side.
To destroy not one, but three parts of the transmitter.
He'll be as good as dancing with a public toilet without a penny.
Slowly. Here now.
Here.
This person.
I say, this is becoming rather perilous, to say the least.
I've made a huge mistake.
Oh, my gosh. That one. I've pulled it as well as a dentist pulls a rotten tooth. There.
Move faster if you can.
I see. This is becoming rather perilous, to say the least. Holy gosh, Templar!
Need some muscle, Miss Frye.
My dears, Jacob, Evie. Thanks are once again in order for supporting what is most dear to me and to our cause, freedom of speech.
It's a blessing that you employ your genius for the common good, Alec.
However, I suggest you vacate your workshop.
No need. Not now. You've given me sacks full of courage. And besides, what with my little devices, I have all the protection I need. Should you find yourselves with a moment to spare, do drop by.
I don't want to hurt you.
To hold! Them knights can work! Help a poor old man be safe from the street rats!
You can just get over that! Get my way to touch you!
Be safe from the street rats! Help a poor old man be safe from the street rats!
Take me in. I'm all yours, lady.
Now settle down, Mr. Sedgwick.
So was he. He called for his pipe and he called for his bow and he called free.
Come on! We've been challenged to a gang fight!
Miss Edith Swinburne has agreed to your terms. Everything is permitted in this gang fight. The wager is ownership of the Thames. Good luck.
Work for us.
Excellent.